Many of us have been asked to find X, but for something to be found, it must first have been lost. On the number line, life was well defined. With prized fields and blue skies, things were pretty organized. Until one non-ordinary day, when all patterns went astray. This is the story of X, who was born to shock and surprise with an equation too tough to analyze. X's parents were 40 and 42, but after 41 came between them, 40 had moved on with someone new. Growing up, X's life felt far from optimal, since without a value, how can one be valuable? One day, a school trip to the function fair turned to despair when X was told, "You must have this value to ride," and was sent instead to the minimal slide. That night at the times table, relational emotions were unstable. X blamed 42 for their missing value. 42 snapped back, "It isn't all about you. If only you were numeric, that would simplify my life too. I'm tired of this pointless search for your value." X slammed their door and began to cry. 42 cooled off, knocked, but no reply. "X, I'm sorry for what I said to you. I was out of order. It wasn't true. Please know that I value you." But already outside, eyes blurred by misery, X had not heard 42's apology. Untying their old boat, cold and scared, X hadn't realized that their pain was shared. Every night, 42 worked on finding X. Even when the math became complex, 42 worked with increased ferocity. Their working was an absolute monstrosity. They'd even found a fictional velocity. X sailed out far into the ocean, battling the elements and their emotions, when a sinusoidal storm rose with an unbalanced force, sending the boat and X curving off course. Spotting an island, X gave a shout before the boom swung round and knocked X out. Washed up on the beach, X barely survived, but was discovered by a group of eyes. Part of an ancient numerical civilization who had an archaic system of classification. X woke to an emperor's voice, who peered down, giving X no choice. "This one will be useful later. I declare them a 10, a gladiator." Then M leaned down with a menacing demeanor and said, "You can prove your value in the arena." X thought maybe they'd found a way to belong with this group of tens so big and strong. But something felt so terribly wrong. Everyone expected X to fight. Swords drawn, the crowd roared with delight. When two angles of radiant light flew through X's line of sight, their movement inspired X to try, folding up into an eye. This way, X escaped from the jailhouse, grateful for all the practice of trying to be someone else. Then, down the shaft of an old mine, X fell to the access line. Lost in a dark and dingy nook, X discovered an ancient book. It spanned all of mathematics, from algebra to geometry to quadratics. X was shocked to see on almost every page that their name was center stage. Blinking, bewildered, it made no sense. X flicked to the back with suspense where the answers should be listed, but nothing there. No answers existed. The walls around X then congruently shifted. Glowing beads on an abacus drifted to reveal a bright and welcoming direction. Much better than here, X thought on reflection. X was on cloud 9. This place was divine. It was hard to define, but unlike anything else on the number line. There were strange symbols X had never seen before. It wasn't clear what they even stood for. One said, "Hello, X, come through. I'm Y. It's nice to meet you." Welcome to the origin, the place where number lines begin. Y was the first unknown X had talked to, so X asked, "Do you know your value?" Y nodded, replying, "And so shall you. Let me change your point of view." Y led X on a tour of math that was wonderfully obscure. Then Y said, "Knowing your value can be an irrational endeavor. Pi knows theirs, but will be chasing it forever. You must come to grips with the fact math is not about your value. Math is about relationships." You and I can form a line, a circle, or an ellipse. We're like magicians with transformative tricks. And with that, the whole grid is at our fingertips. Seeing that it's okay to be unknown, X said, "Let's solve this problem of getting me home." On X's return, 42 was overjoyed, saying, "Life without you felt like zero, a complete void." X felt a healing deep in their heart at this reunion of broken parts. 42 invited X into their exclusive space, where there was a briefcase full of equations and formulae half erased. 42 proved to X that they'd always been working, never given up hope, never stopped searching. X and 42 embraced, X happily crying to see how hard 42 had been trying. Before the papers could cause any more pain, X threw them out into a new domain. An answer was no longer needed, and as the tears receded, X said, "To To blame you, 42, was wrong. I've found my value. It was here, all along.